Good afternoon, Fairborn. This is City Manager Rob here. We're coming live from the city building. With me today is Lee Harris, our city engineer. Lee, welcome.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
And we're going to talk to you about street maintenance. One of the big questions that we get has to do a lot with what our road projects are, how we maintain our roads, why don't you pave more roads, why don't you take care of this? So we thought we'd get the expert in the room here and ask him some questions about what projects we have coming up and what our plan is going forward for 2019. I know it's hard to visualize it, Lee, now that we got snow on the ground and everything frozen, but we have a lot of projects coming up this year. What's a couple of them that we're working on in 2019?
Okay, we actually have a lot of really big projects coming up here this year. Our first one's gonna be our Kaufman and Colonel Glenn Roundabout. We're putting a roundabout there at that intersection, hoping to make that intersection more safe, and then also allow people to kind of free flow through that intersection so they don't have to stop at a light every time if no one's there.
So I know that whenever I'm on Kaufman, turn left on Herman Glen, I stop no matter what, and there's nobody in that intersection, so it's frustrating.
It is.
And I know we get a lot of questions about why a roundabout, what are we doing, you know, maybe just talk about the benefits of it, how it makes the intersection a little better.
Okay. Well, the roundabout's going to make that intersection a little bit safer. We're going to be coming up, you'll be able to slow down to a slower pace than if you were to come up on at an intersection right now and it's a green light, you can kind of take it at speed. With this one, it's going to make you slow down, take a look at your surroundings, you make sure there's no pedestrians, and then you can kind of move through the intersection.
Great.
As well as if there's no one at the intersection, then you can just traverse the roundabout like normal. You'll still take it at a slow pace and be able to continue on your way without having to stop. It makes it a little more efficient because you're not waiting at a red light.
Sure. And it helps us too because then we're no longer maintaining signals and we can take that infrastructure out.
And that's one of the other things. That's a very old signal the city has to go out there and maintain. They do a lot of maintenance trips out there each year. So taking that out of our system is going to help drastically on our maintenance costs.
So. Great. So that's one of our big projects I know a lot of people talk about. What's another big one right in the same area?
The next one is in coordination with that one. We're going to be widening Kaufman Avenue. The widening is going to be occurring right there in front of the old Elder Beerman's for the most part.
Sure.
So between Lindbergh and then down to around just after Garland where that comes in.
Okay.
And then we're going to be resurfacing the rest of Kaufman all the way from Lindbergh to Cumberland.
So you can kind of see how wide the street's going to be with the area that's already been wide, correct?
Yes.
So we're essentially going to match that curb line?
All the way through, yes.
Okay.
We'll be doing there'll be some drainage improvements through there as well, and some signal improvements there at Garland. So.
And the good news is we won't be messing with the bike path that just got paved last year, right?
That's
going to be exactly the same.
All that's going to stay the same. We worked with the county when they did that project, and we made sure that the bike path was put into the location that our project wasn't going to affect.
And it's going to be a brand new street. Everything's going to be smooth as you drive through there, right?
Yes, it is.
Good. I know that's one of the areas that we get talked about a lot. What else? We got one more project that we're doing. Smaller section, but a good one.
Yes, so we have one more larger project. It's going to be on Broad Street.
Okay.
That's going to go from Sandhill Road to Spangler. We're widening that out from two lanes to three lanes.
Great.
And then putting a multi-use path on one side.
Awesome.
So we're planning on that being kind of a catalyst for that area. It'll bring in development, get more people interested in developing in that area, and just making it more of a commercial feel to that corridor.
Great. And now, that's the first phase of a much bigger project for Broad Street down the line. So talk a little bit about how we do that and what the project is.
Okay, so that is phase one. We're going to look at having maybe 3 to 4 phases of Broad Street improvements. We're in the process of looking at the second phase now. We're going to focus on the downtown section there, which is going to go from Dayton Drive about up to Pierce Drive. We're going to look at doing some roadway improvements there, making it more of a downtown friendly corridor, sort of looking at doing some either bike lanes, bike paths, making some improvements for bikes, pedestrians, doing some streetscape improvements down there, making it look more like our main street downtown as well.
Okay, great. Now what's the, you know, I think a lot of people would ask, why don't you just pave the whole thing at once? I know why we don't do that, because it's primarily cost, but talk about how some of these projects get funded, and why, when we say something is going to be done, maybe we aren't doing it this year, but it's going to be maybe a year away from doing that.
So one of the reasons we can't do the entire street all at once is funding. That is a big issue. So one of the things the engineering division does is we go out and we apply for grants to the state.
Sure.
And those grants, when we apply for them, they don't actually, we don't get them right away. They have to forecast those out several years. So usually it's 5-6 years down the line that we actually get the money. So we kind of break up projects into manageable sections so that we can maximize the amount of funding that we can get for those larger projects.
Makes sense. I mean, you know, we, there's not unlimited resources, right? And a lot of those projects are very costly to do. I know one of the projects that we get questioned about the most, and I'll admit is probably our worst section of road in town, is Central Avenue, really right in front of the YMCA. So from the railroad tracks to Dayton Drive. Why can't we pave that road, Lee?
We can't pave that road is because we got grant funding for it.
Okay.
So we, State Route 444 got relocated. Right then and there, we knew we were going to have issues.
Sure.
So we went, we talked with the state, and got some grant funding for it. Well, those grant funds are not eligible. We're not able to get those until next year. So we've got plans in the process. We're putting those together now, and we're going to be ready to resurface and basically reconstruct that entire roadway from base up because of how bad it is.
Great.
So we're going to be taking care of that here next year.
Great. So again, that is a complete restructuring of that, reconstruction of that road from the very base down to the dirt, essentially, rebuilding all the gravel, all of the piping in there. We're going to rebuild the whole thing, right?
Yep.
So that it's now a brand new road next year.
Mm-hmm. And it's going to be able to handle all that truck traffic that got converted over from that old State Route 444 to basically our local roadway.
Sure. And we're not talking, this isn't like the difference between paying $10,000 and $15,000. This is a multi-million dollar project, right?
Yes. So I believe our estimate right now for that central reconstruction is $1.5 million.
Right. So it's not an insignificant amount of money. We don't keep that, we don't have that kind of money to build into roads. When we do have a project that size, the reason we wait is we get 80% grant funding, right, in some cases?
Yeah, for this one, we're getting a good amount of money from the state for the top 3 inches, which I think is about $300,000 to $400,000 there, but we also got some OPWC funds with that.
Great.
So we'll be getting some funds as well, so I think they're paying for another portion up to, I think that one's closer to 70%.
Yeah, so when you see things that aren't happening, we completely understand that Central Avenue needs to be done, but it's not as simple as just putting some new asphalt on the road. It's a complete rebuild, and if we want to do it right and do it the smart way, we leverage other resources and we try to bring other money to bear so that we're not footing the bill for that whole thing. So I know in talking to like our county engineer and the folks at NVRPC, kudos to you guys for being so savvy with how you get grant funds to leverage with our own funds. So I know other agencies are very complimentary of how you guys go about doing that.
Well, I know that at least in all my conversations and going to the NVRPC meetings, we're continually up there is receiving grants up there along with all the other major cities like Dayton and Beaver Creek. So I think that is, I'd say we deserve kudos to be up there and being able to get all the money that we do get.
It's just a smart way to play the game.
Right? I agree.
The one thing that we also want to hit on is, so we do a lot of road construction projects where we rebuild roads, we repave, but we also maintain a heck of a lot of pavement each year. I know we've taken some flack for a couple of our practices, but what are some of the ways that we maintain our existing pavement? So let's say, for example, we do pave a road 2 years ago. How do we make sure that we get the most longevity out of that roadway as we possibly can?
We do a lot of different maintenance activities on it. One of the things that we've incorporated here over the last couple of years, we do a surface sealing treatment. We put this on 1 year after we go through and do a full mill and fill, so we resurface the roadway. What that does is it kind of, it's like a Thompson's water seal for your pavement.
Makes sense.
So you put it on, it makes all the water kind of shed off. It keeps the pavement dry so that the water doesn't infiltrate down in and create potholes. So that's one thing that we're doing. Another thing that we do is crack sealing.
Okay.
So you're not going to be able to stop pavement from cracking. It's just, it's always going to crack sometime.
Sure.
So when it does, we usually go out with a crack sealing program here. It's usually about 3 to 5 years after we've put it down when the cracks have started to form.
Sure.
We start sealing those up to keep the water out because, as you know, water gets down into the pavement, into the cracks. It freezes, expands, cracks get bigger, then potholes start forming.
Sure.
So that's one major way that we can keep our roads lasting. And then we also do other treatments like microsurfacings, which with those, the first thing that you do is you seal all the cracks before you put a microsurfacing down because you want to stop those cracks from going back through your new surface, and then we put a thin layer on it to kind of help seal that up and make it give it a good rideable surface and increase friction value so you're not sliding into other cars and other things. So,
and we don't have the benefit of a constant temperature or constant climate year round. So weather like the one we've had, the polar vortex where it's 15 degrees below zero, is not really good for pavement, right?
No, it causes the pavement, as you probably know, temperature causes things to swell. When you get real cold, it causes it to shrink.
Right.
So when you get down that cold, you shrink a lot, it starts causing more cracks to form, which is kind of a never-ending cycle. We have to keep going back out and crack sealing, and you let the cracks expand, and you go back out and do it again.
And the last point I want to make about the maintenance of the roads is that, we rely on a lot of different sources, our own expertise, but we also research the proper ways to go about maintaining roadways. We use accepted standards, national standards. We're not making this stuff up. This is tried and true methods that we use to maintain our pavement.
Yes, and all these are used pretty much over the entire United States.
Sure.
So it's not just us. We didn't just come up with these willy-nilly. We've researched them and they do work.
I've seen crack sealing used in Dublin, Ohio.
Yes.
I'm sure they use it in Dublin, Ireland too, but
yes.
In Dublin, Ohio, which makes me feel better about us using it if they're willing to do it.
Yeah, I've seen it everywhere I've gone. I worked down in Florida for the last couple of years and
sure.
Used it all over down there. You can go to any affluent community, and that's one of the easiest and most cost-effective ways to maintain your roadways. So.
Great. Well, Lee, thanks for being here.
Glad to be here.
This is your first Facebook Live, so you did well.
I appreciate it. Hopefully we answered a lot of the questions here that the public has, and I'm always open if they have any other questions. Feel free to call the engineering office, and I'll do my best to help them.
And I'm sure there's probably already been some comments on this Facebook Live. If not, if you have comments and questions, respond to this social media post. Send us a message through social media, we'll get to the right person. Or if you want to respond to the engineering department directly, please do that. We're here to answer any questions you have. We're trying to be as transparent as we can be. We don't have anything to hide. We're just trying to give you as much information as you possibly could have. So, Lee, thanks for being here. It is cold out, so please stay warm. I know school's been off for the last few days. My kids love it. They've had a five-day weekend. So as you're out and about, please give our snowplows some room. They need some room to operate. If you have cars parked on the street, please move those to the driveway so we can get curb to curb with our snow removal and get our salt down so we can get this stuff melted away. So with that, thanks for joining us. Next month, we'll have another Facebook Live. We'll talk about another topic, which escapes me right now. I'm not quite sure what that is, but we'll put that information out for you. If you have questions, let me know. Always like and share this and comment on this as well. Follow me, City Manager Rob, on Instagram, and we'll give you as much information as we can. See you.